Hello friends, welcome to another video on Tutorialspoint with me, Richa. And today under the retail segment, we are going to talk about cashiering. Well friends, cashiering is one of the most important functions under retail because it is at this place where the transaction of goods and services happens. And it is the cashier's duty to make sure that he accepts the cash or kind from the customers and returns them back the correct change. Hence today we will talk about cashiering in detail. Let's get started. Well, on the agenda today, we will talk about identifying the essential skills, the qualities which are required for a good cashier. Identifying that what exactly is the customer expectation from a cashier. Know the cash desk operation during the opening hours of the store, the business hours as well as the closing hours of the store. Understand the importance of a password. So let's understand cashiering now. Well, there are certain skills which are required to be a good cashier and what these skills are. A cashier needs to have accuracy, he needs to have good speed, efficiency, focus and a fair amount of IT knowledge. Well, the reason being that it is very essential to understand a customer spends a lot of time and energy while buying the kind of products that he or she wishes to buy. When they come to the cashiering point, the customers do not have the patience as well as they do not want to wait for long at the cash point. They just want to finish off the cash dealing and rush back home. So here it is very important that a good cashier should be really accurate and punctual as well as very, very speedy with the transaction. Nobody likes waiting on a long queue to make sure that the cash point happens quickly. Well, there are certain qualities which are required out of a good cashier. Skills are something that you can acquire over a period of time, but it is the quality which is your basic nature and attitude in life. So let's quickly look at what are these qualities of a good cashier. A good cashier should have responsibility, he should have promptness, he should have integrity issues as well as being proactive. Well, friends, these are not qualities which can be taught to a cashier. It is something which is his natural talent or ability. Integrity is a very important factor because a cashier is dealing with cash. He is dealing with credit cards and he cannot goof up over there because it can be an integral issue. He also needs to be having responsibility towards his work. He should be able to be proactive in his dealing with the customer. He should initiate conversation with the customer. So, well, friends, these are certain qualities which are required out of a good cashier. Now, let's look at what are the customer expectations at a cash counter or at the cashiering desk. Well, a customer wants the cashier to be polite and friendly. Nobody likes talking to a cashier who's rude and who's not really upcoming in his conversations. So they really want them to be polite and friendly. Fast and accurate billing process. A customer would hate it if a particular cashier is not fast with his transaction and a customer has to wait in a long queue. So they really expect the cashier to know his mathematics, to know his calculations, and being able to have an accurate and fast billing process. All billing counters should be functioning during a rush or a peak hours. Now friends, I'm sure you have visited malls as well as other retail outlets during a EOSS, which is end of season sale. During sale and during discount and even during peak hours, there is a lot of rush and nobody really likes waiting at a long queue during these hours. So at that point of time, all the billing counters need to be open and functioning and not just one counter because there will be a long queue there. Manual billing carried out in case of any technical goof-ups or technical problems. Here it is essential to understand that if there is a technical problem, there has to be manual billing. Let's quickly look at what is the role of a cashier during the store opening. Well, during a store opening, he has to receive the float cash. Float cash is a petty amount of cash which is given to a cashier right at the start of the store opening so that he has change ready with him. Login using the password. Now, this is very essential for a cashier to know what is his login ID and his password. Arrange the cash denomination-wise in the cash drawer. It has to be really neatly and organized well inside the drawer. Get ready with all the required stationery. Now let's look at what is the required stationery which a cashier should have handy with him when he starts the store opening. Certain things that a cashier needs to have is a stapler. He needs to have some stapler pins because a stapler without pins is of no use. He should have the bill rolls ready, scissors, a pair of pen, hard tack detectors, which he needs to detect for certain garments, in the store, which have only a hard tag, and those could be detected only by a hard tag detector, and an EDC machine roll. EDC machines are where you will swipe the credit card or the debit card of the customer. Hence, friends, these are important things which a cashier should have with him ready before the store opens for the customers. Let's look at what is the role of a cashier during the business hours or while the billing process is happening. There is a certain protocol which a cashier needs to follow during these business hours. He needs to first of all greet the customer with a pleasant good morning, good afternoon, or good evening according to the time of the day. He needs to scan the products of the customer. He needs to conduct add-on sale. Add-on sale is something that you want to add to the customer's list of things that he's already bought. For example, if a customer has bought a pair of socks, a cashier can also sell some other kind of socks, which could be, adding to his or her ticket size of the product. Confirm the mode of payment. A cashier needs to ask the customer whether he would like to pay by card or by cash. He needs to check for the loyalty card and receive the payment. Now, every other retail outlets, and I'm talking about the big retail outlets like Pantaloons, Lifestyle, Shoppers Stop, etc., they all have loyalty program, and these members who have loyalty cards get additional discounts on their cards, or rather they have certain points accumulated. A cashier always needs to ask any person who's in front of him, any customer, about whether he has these loyalty cards. He needs to check for the security tag, and that has to be intact. He needs to pack the product neatly into a plastic bag, and he needs to thank the customer while he's ending the billing process. Friends, this is a very important cycle which each and every cashier needs to follow with each and every customer. Let's look at the role of the cashier during a closure of the business hours. He needs to arrange the cash denomination wise into the cash drawer because there should not be any mix up of cash. Ensure that closing happens in the process or in the presence of a head cashier. All the cashiers report into the head cashier or the manager. So the total ending of the sale should happen, or closure should happen, in the presence of a head cashier. Declare and hand over float cash to the head cashier or the manager. Now remember, he had received the float cash at the beginning or the store opening. He needs to hand over all of that back to the head cashier. Tally the charge slips and generate the report from the EDC machine. He needs to declare and hand over the sales amount to the head cashier. Whatever has been the sale of that entire day, he needs to collect everything and hand it over to the head cashier. Tally and enter the total sales amount into the system. Whatever system he is working in, he needs to tally all of that sale with the amount of cash or card received. Well, a cashier has to work on an operator number and a password which is given to him for each and every cashier who's working in a retail outlet. He needs to have an operator number and password. Each cashier is provided with a unique operator number and password, which is only for his use, and he cannot share this operator password with anybody else. These numbers allow the cashier to enter into the billing mode. Cashier should maintain confidentiality and is responsible for any kind of misuse. A cashier cannot share this password with anybody, and he cannot misuse the password for his or her own purposes. Well, friends, that brings us to the end of this particular module on cashiering. We have understood a lot in detail about the roles and responsibilities and the good qualities and skills required to be a good cashier. I do hope you have enjoyed listening to this particular module on cashiering. Thank you.